Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss a new topic in the partnership, that is types of partnership. So be focused on the topic. So students, partnership can be divided into different types on the basis of duration and liability. So firstly, we will discuss types of partnership on the basis of duration. Let's see students, on the basis of duration, partnership can be of two types. First is partnership at will and second is particular partnership. So firstly, I will discuss partnership at will. Partnership at will is that type of partnership which is based on the will of the partners. These type of partnership are done for an indefinite period of time. It depends on the will of the partners. If partners wants, they can continue the partnership for a long period of time. And if any of the partner want to leave the partnership firm, that partner has to give notice to the firm. In this way, the partnership will go to end. And if remaining partners want to continue the partnership, they have to make a new agreement. So students, this is about partnership at will. Now second type of partnership is particular partnership. This is that partnership which is done for a particular project, like construction of any flyover, construction of any bridge or dam. Or you can say this particular partnership is done for a specific activity, but for a specific period of time. So when that project will be completed, partnership, particular partnership will go to end. And if partners have done partnership for a specific activity for a specific period of time, then when period will be over, partnership will go to end. So this is called as particular partnership. This is either for the particular project or for a particular period of time. This partnership depends on the will of the partners. Now students, we will move to the next type, that is partnership on the basis of liability. So on the basis of liability, again partnership can be of two types: general or ordinary partnership, limited partnership. So firstly, I will discuss general or ordinary partnership. Students, I will tell you five things about general partnership and five things about the limited partnership. So be focused what I am saying. In case of general partnership, all the partners have unlimited liability. This is the first thing I am telling you. Second one, all the partners are allowed to participate in the management of the firm. Third thing, any agreement signed by one partner will bind the other partners as well as firm. Fourth thing, death, lunacy, insolvency or bankruptcy of any of the partner result in the dissolution of whole firm, means firm will go to end. And last thing I am telling you about general partnership is that registration is optional, it is not mandatory. So this is all about general or ordinary partnership. Now I will tell you about limited partnership. So first thing about limited partnership is that only one partner is having unlimited liability and other partners, all the remaining partners, have limited liability. So the partners who are having limited liability, they are called as limited partners. Second thing, limited partners are not allowed to participate in the management of the firm. Third thing, death, lunacy, insolvency or bankruptcy of the limited partners will not affect the life of the firm. Fourth thing is that any of the contract signed by limited partners will not bind other partners as well as firm. And the last thing is that registration is mandatory. So this is all about limited partnership. So students, here our topic of types of partnership is completed. Now we will discuss one more topic today, that is partnership deed. Okay? Yes, partnership deed. Yes, students, you all know that partnership is formed on the basis of agreement. And
whether the agreement is written or oral, it depends on the partners. But it is advisable that agreement should be in the written form. Because if the agreement is in the written form, there will not be any chance of dispute in the coming future. So students, the document which contains terms and conditions of partnership agreement is called as partnership deed. So what I am saying, I am repeating once more, the document containing terms and conditions of partnership agreement, that document is called as partnership deed. Now students, we will discuss what are the contents or clauses of partnership deed. So see, the first content, name and address of the partnership firm and partners. In partnership deed, it is written what is the name of partnership firm as well as address of the partnership firm, and then name of the partners as well as their address. After that, nature of business. Nature of business is specified in the partnership deed, that whether it is a trading business or manufacturing business. Next, location of business. Where business is located, in which district, in which state. Then, amount of capital invested. Then it is mentioned in the deed that which partner has invested what amount of capital and what is the total capital of business. That is mentioned in the deed. Next, duration of partnership. What is the duration of partnership? Whether it is partnership on the basis of will or on the basis of particular partnership. If it is particular, then what is the duration? So that is mentioned in the partnership deed. Then, profit sharing ratio. That what is the profit sharing ratio of the partners. After that, amount of salary and commission. If partners are to be given any amount of salary or commission, then that will also be specified in the partnership deed. After that, procedure of preparation of accounts as well as auditing. In the partnership deed, it is mentioned what is the procedure of preparing accounts, whether single entry system is used or double entry system is used, and how auditing will be done. Auditing means checking of accounts, that whether accounts are prepared properly or not. After that, duties or responsibilities of the partner. What are the duties and responsibilities of partners? Means what is the type of liability, whether partners are having limited liability or unlimited. So if partners have limited liability, it means their duties and responsibilities are less. And if partners have unlimited liability, their duties and responsibilities are more. Then next is procedure of dissolution. How firm will be dissolved. Dissolved means how firm will go to end. The method of dissolution will also be specified in the partnership deed. These are the important contents of partnership deed, which I discussed with you. But students, this is not the final list. The contents of the partnership deed may vary.
Firm to firm depends on the nature and objective of the firm. So students, here the topic of partnership deed is ended. I hope both the topic, types of partnership and partnership deed are clear to all of you. Even then, if you have any doubt, you can ask from me. Okay, students? Thank you, students.